In this slide, we are going to talk about benefits of OCI Queue service. OCI Queue service, or OQS, is a fully managed, serverless, high throughput, highly available queuing service capable of ingesting millions of messages per second, and it eliminates overhead of managing message-oriented middleware. Users can publish, consume, delete messages, and they can update visibility timeout of the message as well. OQS helps to decouple applications and scale them independently. It also supports dead letter queue and ensures messages are not lost if not acknowledged by consumer. OQS supports REST and industry-leading Storm protocol, as well as SDK in multiple languages. So let's talk about one of the solution architecture which we have for Oracle Queue service, which is a typical producer consumer scenario and which is pretty common in case of any asynchronous queue service. So if we see the on the left hand side, we have a producer which can be hosted anywhere, and the producer can be anything. It can be a simple application which is hosted on your desktop and sending message, or it can be a web application which is sending message to OQS, or it can be any other application which is interacting with the Oracle Queue service. So producer is sending messages. So message can be anything. So you can send JSON message, you can send XML message, you can send a text message, you can send a binary message to Oracle Queue service. On the right hand side, we have a consumer app which is hosted in Oracle Kubernetes Engine. So consumer app typically consumes the message. When we say consume the message, it processes the message. So processing messages can be done in various ways. I mean, it can pass it to the further any other consumer app, or it can save it in the database, it can save it in object storage, or it can send it to the further any other queue or any other service. However, in this case, we are just going to process it to showcase how the message is processed. And then we are going to acknowledge it back to the Oracle Queue service that the consumer has successfully processed the message. And we will send the acknowledgement, which is basically we are going to make a delete call. Now we will also see that how consumers will scale up based on the queue size. Queue size we are going to check by using a Oracle function, which is exposed using an API, using API gateway, and it calls a queue status API of the Oracle Queue service. And based on this, based on the number of messages in the queue, we scale the consumers. And how the consumers are scaled up, we use a metric-based scaler, which is called KEDA. KEDA stands for Kubernetes Event-Driven Autoscaler. And it scales the number of ports. So consumer app is basically hosted as a single pod, but when it says the number of messages are increasing in the queue, it starts scaling up from one to n, like we have set the limit, which we will see in action soon. And it starts scaling the number of consumers. And once the number of messages starts going down, it starts scaling down. And our image is hosted, consumer app is, image of the consumer app is hosted in the Oracle container registry, and same for the Oracle function. We will see the now producer consumer demo in action, how our consumers are going to scale up, and how the consumers are going to match with the speed of producer. So just we will see how the get state API works. So let's see get state, and then we will start our producer. So right now we can see the visible messages are zero. So I'm doing it in every 5 seconds. this check, and visible messages are zero, in-flight messages are zero, DLQ visible messages are zero, and DLQ in-flight messages are zero. So it will soon start increasing, and I'm going to start the producer. But before we start the producer, let's see our consumers. So right now we have, this is my deployment, and deployment name is QOK, which I have just explained. And you see right now we don't have any ports because there are no messages in the queue. So once we start pushing the messages in the queue using producer, soon consumers will start scaling up as messages start going down or going up. And I'm starting producer now, which is hosted on a virtual machine. And I'm starting producer, and you can see it will be pretty fast. We will also see the message latency, which is in typically in milliseconds, less than 100 milliseconds, in the same reason. On the right-hand side, we can see now the visible messages are increasing. Right now, there are zero in-flight messages. And in-flight messages now will keep increasing. Right now, the visible messages will be more because consumers will take some time to catch up. You can also see the latency, which is less than 100 milliseconds. It is in 20 and 30 milliseconds. And the total message count is increasing, but our in-flight messages are less right now. And let's go to consumer side and see how. So now our consumers have started scaling up. You can see that we have 8 ports ready. So new ports are getting created, and you can see how fast our new consumers are getting up and running. So we can see the visible messages are increasing, and so are our in-flight. It will take some time to catch up because if you can recall, I have introduced a 1 millisecond delay for every message so that consumers can process the message, as well as I am also calling the delete message API. So due to that, there is some amount of delay on the consumer side, but on the producer side, we don't have any delay, and we are sending 20 messages in every call. So that's why we have the higher the number of consumers, but single producer on the producer side. And let's quickly check the, so we can see that we have number of ports which are running is 64, and we have all 75 ports are in place now. And let's see the visible messages. So right now it's 30,000 messages, though the producer has pushed around 100K messages, and soon producer and consumer will match the speed of producing and the consuming of messages. And number of in-flight messages will increase as we move forward. The specific logs like this, which we have just shown that how each consumer is processing the messages, and the estimated time and all those things are in place. So we can see that we can also view the visible messages from queue console, and it's auto refresh. So now consumers are matching with the producer soon, one level up, and you can see it from here also. And as well as you can see, there are no messages in the dead letter queue because all the messages are getting processed successfully. So we can see that number of visible messages are going down, and the number of in-flight messages are more now. So soon we will see that number of messages are probably in less than 100, or it is getting consumed as soon as producer is producing it. So see some of our ports are restarting. So KEDA is already in action. And we all, we have almost all of our reports are in action now. And we'll see that our consumers are now scaling down. So I will stop the producer. And we will see that KEDA will start scaling down our consumers pretty soon. Since we have defined 2 minutes of cooldown period, so it will take some time. And post that, it will scale down all the consumers. So we can see that after waiting for some time, since we have defined 2 minutes of cooldown period, now since we have stopped the producers and there are no messages in the queue, which we can see from here, visible message 0, in-flight messages 0. So is DLQ and DLQ in-flight messages. So that's why all our consumers are down now. Since scaled down now, KEDA has scaled it down, and you can see the 0 ports here.